Hello and welcome to Gaming Pickups, the movie. I'm only calling it a movie because I have a lot of stuff to show. Now, it has been a very long time since the last one. And that's mostly because I've wound down the Gaming Pickups. And now we're coming up to Christmas. I've ramped it back up by accident. And I kind of went a little bit overboard, because instead of letting people get gifts for me, I've ended up getting gifts for myself. Somehow. Don't ask me how that worked out, but that's the way it did. So I'm going to somehow tell you guys what on earth I've managed to pick up. Now, I did a little teaser in my Discord. Yes, I have a Discord. And there's a lot of games there, and that's just pile number one. There's a lot to get through, so let's get underway. Gaming Pickups, coming at you live through a YouTube video. Yes, not live. There's too much here, and it would never get done, and it would be about 5 hours long if it was live. So let's do this recorded. Plus, it's been a while since I've been out of the game. So, let's start with the ones I haven't got on me right now, because I'm too lazy to get them from up there. Basically, I've picked up quite a few collector's editions of games because I like the figures. First of all, being the Marcus Fenix from Gears of War. Boom. Wherever I'm going to end up throwing this, I don't know. I haven't planned the video ahead that far, just only that I'm going to throw a picture of it because he's right there. But blown up picture, wherever the hell I throw it. So basically, I've got Marcus Fenix, and I also got the Doom collector's edition as well. That should be pretty fun. Look, it's pretty awesome. It lights up. I'm too lazy to get a picture of it actually lit up because I have to put new batteries in it. Effort. I also got the Far Cry 4 one and also the Modern Warfare one. I can't remember which Modern Warfare one that one is, but it's a picture of Captain Soap McTavish, which is pretty darn cool. May he rest in peace. But hey, hopefully he's in the reboot. Another reboot. Modern Warfare, the new Modern Warfare 2. Whatever they make it. I also got the Dark Souls one, and I also got the Assassin's Creed Odyssey one with Alexios jumping over. Now, I did want the Cassandra version, but I cannot find it anywhere. So I'm just going to have to deal without. I also got, I think it's Splinter Cell Blacklist, Sam Fisher. I think that's the version that I got anyway. And I also got Two Worlds 2 Collected Edition as well. Just throwing those out there. Oh, and the Balls of Steel. Cannot forget about Duke Nukem Balls of Steel. Balls of Steel. And I also got the thingy my Bobby Majiggy. What's it called? Deus Ex. I got that one as well. The augmented one. The one with the figure in. Pretty darn cool. Got that as well. Again, pictures there. That's just to get those ones out the way just because they're too much effort. Now let's get on to the ones I actually do have on me. Let's start off with, well, I got myself a little Pac-Man light. Now, Game, they're having a massive clearance right now. They are clearing out pretty much most of their stock, I'm assuming for the Christmas stock coming out, so they threw this out for a couple of quid. It's literally a Pac-Man light. Apparently there's three versions, because it's Series 1. There's probably never going to be a Series 2, let's face it. And of course, you get Blinky, and you also get the Ghost one as well. Because of course you do. That's pretty darn cool. Yeah, the cute little lights. Let me just quickly show you it lit up. Because I'm going to be taking out this box anyway, just because it's pretty cool. Right, let's just dump that. Pretty cool. Pretty cool indeed. Ah, look, and the focus actually made it darker around it. Clever camera. Clever. But yeah, it's a pretty cool little light. I do like it, and that is definitely going to get pride of place on my shelves. For now, it's going to go there. And it might stay there. I like that. Next. Technically not gaming related, but it technically is because there are Judge Dredd games out there. I've played them. I even played one on my phone with a keyboard and mouse. Yes. Pretty darn cool. Yeah, Judge Dredd. Now this one's the 1-12 collective. I don't know much about it except that it's very pricey. Very, very pricey. And I got it for not very pricey, because of course I did, but a little bit more than I expected. But still, hey, way cheaper than eBay, so I'll take that all day, every day. And also, it's one of the coolest figures ever. Hold on, I think I can actually show you, because it actually has one of those front-facing windows. Can't really make that out very well, because it's very, very, very reflective. There we go. It's pretty darn cool. I love Judge Dredd, love the universe, even though the universe is completely horrible, but hey, aren't the most popular universes the most broken? Judge Dredd, Fallout, Warhammer 40k, yeah, they are pretty dismal. I guess we like dismal universes. Oh, and Terminator, love that world. Whichever one they decide to land on, because they keep retconning. Hey, it's just Game of Pickups. Speaking of Game of Pickups, I got these. Again, like I said, Game is having a massive clearance. This is Totaku. Totaku have made like over 100 figures from various gaming franchises, and they are really, really well made, well sculpted figures, and they are all around about this size, so they're not the smallest thing in the world, but they are pretty nice. I do already have a whole bunch of them, because I bought them from Game before, and now they're gone on even more clearance, and while we were away on holiday to York, and subsequently Leeds on the way back, we got a ton more. I got 7 more to add to my collection of already... How many have I got? Oh, I've got a couple of pictures here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. I've just got loads. Literally loads. I've got ones from Lemmings, Crash Bandicoot, Banjo-Kazooie, Spyro, Horizon Zero Dawn, God of War. I've just got loads of really awesome ones. And now I've added these ones to my collection. Of course, I've got Ryu from Street Fighter. Very, very nice. Next up, I've got... one of the Wipeout cars. Okay, pretty cool. I'll take that. Also got Hihachi. I can't remember how to pronounce it. Hihachi. I think it's Hihachi. Oh, whatever. From Tekken, of course. I want to get the rest of them. I need all of them. This one made my friend very jealous. Ni No Kuni. Yes, this is Evan. I do love the Ni No Kuni games. I did really like Ni No Kuni 2. Unfortunately, it didn't really... I don't think it... took off over here in the West, which is a big shame, because it's a very, very, very fun game. Of course, I got Parappa from Parappa the Rapper. Iconic. Well, I do wish they'd bring out more games from Parappa the Rapper. And then I got these because they were literally £2 from the game. They were just clearancing them. So, yeah. Mitsurugi? I don't know him. From Soul Calibur 6? I don't know. I don't even have Soul Calibur 6, but hey, I got a figure from him. It's pretty darn cool. I also have a Dark Souls figure up there as well. Yes, of course I do. So yes, I also got Solveig from Battlefield 5. I'm assuming because the box was knackered, that's why they cheaped it out. Any excuse to make it cheaper. Oh, that also reminded me, I've got a Dark Souls Collector's Edition thing up there as well. I've just got it, never ending, never complaining. And of course, no gaming collection is complete without actually getting gaming food. Gaming food? Gaming food. Fallout, the official cookbook for the Vault Dweller. Oh, that is pretty darn cool. I do like that. I do like that very much. It's still brand new sealed. I haven't even looked at it yet, but I'm going to be making a couple of dishes from this because I think I deserve them. You can make mushroom clouds, apparently. Mystery meat wrapped nuka lurk. You have my attention. Blamco mac and cheese. I imagine it's just regular like recipes from like the 50s and stuff like that, just renamed for Fallout goodness. Well, I'm hoping there's some good ones on there. I don't know. Maybe it's a future video. Maybe. Potentially. It's an idea. I like that idea. Gaming food. What else we got? Picked up these. Because of course I did. This is all the merch, by the way. I've not got to the games yet. The Pokeball Plus for Pokemon Let's Go Pikachu and Eevee. Very, very cool. I do like the way it lights up. It's pretty nice. Unfortunately, this is a pre-owned version, so I imagine the Mew has been redeemed. I kind of hope it hasn't, but it probably has been. I'd do anything to get Mew for my game. It's not fair, and I'm not buying a brand new one to get it. And then I got a Kirby. Because I realized I didn't have a picture of a figure of Kirby for my shelves. So, Here we go. This is the face I got. Apparently, there's a ton of faces you can get. The stand is actually inside of the Kirby sphere, which is pretty darn cool, so we'll put that together at some point. But yeah, there's a ton of different faces you can get. I would have preferred a more, you know, the one with the cheeks, but yeah. I'm not going to buy a million of these, and plus it was only a quid from game. Your store may vary, because the one in Leeds is a hell of a lot more cheaper than the one by mine. I've got a couple by my place, and they're nowhere near as cheap as there. So I'm assuming they had a massive overstock, or maybe they're both doing it, because I've not been to my local ones in a while. Okay, next up. Technically video game related. Technically, I'm really stretching the video game term here, but that's mostly because I got a lot of these from a cute little market stall in the middle of York. Yes, we spent a short while in York, but it was very, very, very well rewarding. I kind of got a ton of Star Trek figures. I literally cleared him out. It was a little market stall, they had a ton of boxes, and I cleared him out of all the Star Trek ones. So, and these are from the 1994, what's it called, collection, which is pretty darn cool. So yeah, I got Benjamin motherfucking Sisko, you gotta call him that. Because if you watch Razor Fist, you'll know why. Also got Riker, because of course I did. I got Vagina Head, Mr. Worf. I even got Kira Nerys. Okay, I will take that. Is it Kira Nerys? Oh god, it's been a while since I've watched Deep Space Nine, dude. And this one, I actually bought after buy off eBay. He didn't have this one, so this one I actually bought and it arrived the other day. Very, very good. Because no point having all of these and not actual Picard himself, you know what I mean? I had Sisko, but not Picard. It's ridiculous. Geordi LaForge, and of course, Lieutenant Commander Data. Of course, now they're not the most resembling of characters, but for 1994, these are very, very well made, and it's nice to actually have not a full set, but a larger the set. And there's a million and one Star Trek games, so it is technically gaming related. Right? Also, I'm slightly hyped for Star Trek Picard, because I hope it's good. I hope it's good. I hope it's not garbage, because everything I know and love seems to be getting destroyed lately, and I don't know whether it's because I'm old or whether they're trying to move on to people younger than me, but I'm only in my 20s, so I don't know. Am I out of touch, or are they? No, it is them who are wrong. Has to be. What else have we got? I think I've gone past the merchy stage, I think. Thank goodness. So let's jump on to controllers. I've got a couple of controllers, only a couple, not loads. This is from a gaming shop called Sore Thumbs. Yes, Sore Thumbs. It was in the middle of York. It's the only independent game store that I could find, and it is, and I talked about this before in last time we went to York. Unfortunately, the video I had was absolutely garbage, so I took it with a better phone. Not mine, though, because my phone had a firmware error. So I had to use the girlfriend's, but hey, still better. The video's a lot better. Here's the video of it now. It's gone. If you want retro games, Sore Thumbs is the place to go. Not even joking. I got piles. Most of these games came from Sore Thumbs. It was very, very good. They've got all the retro games from Atari, NES, SNES, Mega Drive, Master System, even Sega Saturn, PS1, PS2. They had pretty much none of the modern stuff, and even then, I'd class PS3 and 360 as retro now because it's nearing 10 years old. There are people on the internet now that have never played on PS3 and Xbox 360 because it's literally all moved on to PS4 and Xbox One, and then the new ones next year. So, yeah, it's getting retro now. But yeah, this place doesn't have many. They literally had a handful, like 5 PS3 games. That was the latest they had. No Wii or Wii U. I think there was a couple of Wii, actually. I think there was. This was a couple of weeks ago. I'm back now. But yeah, they've got a bit of everything. A lot of anime figures, a lot of old big box PC games. They've got glass cabinets of really, really like rare and a little bit pricier stuff from the NES era. Very, very nice. The prices are good as well. They're not over the eBay prices. They're very, very competitive. Unfortunately, I'm just not in the market for the expensive stuff, and plus I'm a cheap guy. It's what I do, but I still walked out with a ton of games. A ton. And also a couple of controllers. So the first couple of controllers I have is a Quickshot controller for the SNES. pretty darn cool stuff. You guys know I love my arcade controllers, and, well, getting one for Mortal Kombat for my SNES, pretty darn good. Even if it doesn't have all the gore, it's not fair. But yeah, it's pretty darn cool. It's also got some turbo buttons, and it's got a couple of switches on it. Pretty nice. Maybe it's garbage. Don't know. It does feel a bit gummy, but hey, maybe it can get modified with micro switches. Next up, I've got one for... Now, this one was a cool oddity. He actually gave me this one for free because, well, I was just buying a ton of stuff, and he was just a really good guy. Really, you know, good business owner, but also likes the games as well. So, you know, can't go wrong with that. But yeah, Quick Shot for the NES. It's a one-player controller, but it uses two controller ports. Now, whether that's for the power or to switch between Player 1 and Player 2, because it does have a switch for Player 1 and Player 2, but... Why does it have two ports? It boggles the mind because it's not got any like outputs, but it's got two wires. It just takes up two ports. It's very strange. I'll assume it's a power thing, maybe, possibly. But it's pretty cool. It's a cool little oddity, and he let me have it for free because he's nice like that. Pretty darn cool stuff. This one I didn't get from Sore Thumbs because, well, I kind of got it at work because we get a lot of. Well, we do get quite a bit of decent stuff, and I get first pickings. That's why I'm there. Plus, I also actually like the job, which it's actually rare to actually get a job you enjoy. But hey, I've got one. I've been there 2 years now. Pretty cool stuff. First off, Sega Saturn console. I finally jumped into the Sega Saturn market, and I also got a nice bunch of games as well. I also ordered a couple from our sister stores as well, which is pretty good. But yes, boom, Sega Saturn. Works perfectly great because, well, it was me that tested it. So I had to make sure it was working because as soon as I saw it, I was like, well, I already know I'm getting this. May as well play the games. I did get quite a few games for it, but I'll jump onto the games a little bit later because I'd rather show the other new consoles I got as well. Next up being the At-Game Sega Mega Drive. Now, I literally got this because it was cheap. It comes with the two controllers. It's basically the boxed version. It's got everything with it, just without the actual box. And it's got a, yeah, the only reason I got it is because it's actually got a cartridge port, and it uses very little power. It's a good console. The emulation's not perfect, but as for a system on chip, it's very, very good for Mega Drive. So I picked up another Mega Drive to add to the list. I also picked up a spare Super Nintendo. Yes, to add to my other Super Nintendo and my Super Famicom to play my Japanese imports. Pretty darn cool. A little bit yellowed on the front, but other than that, this is the most grey-looking one I've personally seen in real life in a long time. So, very happy to get this. I'm hoping to swap out this part here at some point with a more grey version, or perhaps get some retro brighting on it, maybe. I don't know, I've never done retro branding before, so should be interesting to get in, but it's nice to get another SNES, which is pretty cool. And the last console I picked up, that I'm aware of, unless I see another one, because I've literally powered everything around me, so I'm kind of flim-flamming, is the Sega Master System 2. I'm really trying to get hold of the Master System converter for the Mega Drive, but I cannot for the life of me find a decent priced one. But I will get one eventually, and until then, I actually picked up the Master System 2. Very, very good. Another one that came into work. Very, very nice. Ah, I do like it. I do actually like this. Very nice. Then I realized it was RF. That was fun to tune into the telly, because, fun fact, digital tellies, they don't automatically pick them up. But thankfully, I googled the frequency. Instead of having to search through it like that, going, tune it in, damn it. The auto-tuner's not finding it. Manually put it to it, then fiddle with the wire, and then obviously it could find it, because the frequencies, thankfully, are mostly all the same. Yay. So yes, I had a Master System. So, thankfully, I picked these consoles up before I went to York, and before I bestowed myself upon Sore Thumbs. And so I ended up getting a ton of cartridge games as well. Because, well, because I haven't got a Master System, I need games for my collection. It's time to get them off. I've already only had, because as you guys know, I'm a sucker for, you know, if I go in a charity shop and I find a Master System game for a quid or 2 quid, I'm gonna buy it. Regardless of whether I've got the console or not, because it's a deal. I like deals. So even if I don't keep it, I could always sell it on if I wanted to. If it's worth it, if it's not, doesn't matter. So I picked them up anyway, but hey, I added all these to my collection. First off, I'm just going to go through these because I actually found these in a cash converters in Leeds. Paperboy 2. for the Mega Drive, and Flashback for the Mega Drive. Pretty cool little games. I also found this one as well over there. Two N64 games. Now, I didn't have them, but they were quid a piece, so I grabbed them anyway. Wileye Country Club for the N64, and International Super Soccer 98. I ain't got them. They can add them to the list. And I don't mind sports games from retro consoles, because they're cute. They're cute in their own way. I do like them. I can't even remember where I bought this. I bought this a month or so back. Micro Machines 2 Turbo Tournament for the SNES. And no, I did not pay £15 for it. I know that much. I think I might have got it from work. I'm not too sure. Actually, I think I probably did. I like to keep these prices on, because I like to remind myself that I got a deal, because I got it for less than that. And that's always nice to see how much these were actually going for, a few years ago. So these ones I did get from Sore Thumbs. You can tell because they've actually got the plastic wrapping. So if you see any games that I show you with plastic wrapping on, know that I got it from Sore Thumbs, because they protect every single one of the games they've got. They always put protective covers on everything. The only things they didn't put protective covers on were the Game Boy games, because they're Game Boy games and they're that big. Do not put protective wrapping on them, unless you can afford to. But yeah, little protective sheets around every single one of them, secured away, so there's no way of dust getting inside of it, so it's pretty darn cool. The first one is a Nintendo 64 game called Knife Edge. No idea what it is, because all I did while I was in there was I found games that I thought I didn't have, checked my list, and then bought them, because they were cheap. And because I wanted them in my collection. Because I want to play this. It's got a helicopter on it. I want to play it. Now, one thing I didn't think about prior to this moment was that it's all in plastic wrapping. And it's very reflective. Dan didn't plan ahead. But let's start off with the pile of Master System games. Because I want to jump into that first. Because now I have a Master System. I'm really excited to play these games. And the only one I really played was... Where is it? Sonic the Hedgehog 2 and Sonic the Hedgehog, because it's built into the Master System. Very clever, Sega. I wish more console developers would do that. Imagine if you bought a PlayStation 4 and Xbox One when they first came out, and they came in with built-in games. Built-in games, just built into the system, that you could delete and freely download them back off the store, because people will complain about that. But then again, they've got a ton of free demos online, so I guess it's moot. PlayStation 3, Xbox 360, because not everybody was online at the time. Shush. Let me jump over. But anyway, digressing. Sonic the Hedgehog 2, boxed copy. I don't believe it had the manual. Oh, it does. There you go. That's good to know. Goes with the manual as well. So yeah, I've got one boxed Master System game, but I'll take it, because it came with the console. Other Master System games I got was F-16 Fighter. Pretty darn cool. I also got Laser Ghost. I don't even know what any of these games are. SCI. Completely no idea. Back to the Future 2. Okay, naturally, I was going to buy that. There was no way I wasn't going to. Aztec Adventure. Super Space Invaders. Because, again, why wouldn't I? And the last couple. I'm flying through these as quickly as possible. Transbots. And Disney's Aladdin. Now, I know Aladdin was really, really good on other systems. I have no idea how it is on the Master System. Could be garbage, could not be. One way of finding out is playing it. So that's pretty darn cool. I also got hold of Burai Fighter for the NES. I have no idea what that game is. No idea at all. I want to find out. And this is one of those so bad games it's good, Defender of the Crown. It's all the gameplay I've seen of it in the past, it looked fun to me, but a lot of people didn't enjoy it, but also a lot of people did enjoy it, so hopefully I'm in the camp that does like it, but now I get to actually play it on actual hardware instead of just emulated, so I'll take it. I will take that. This one I actually bought off a friend. Yes, I bought retro games off my friend. I will take that. I will take that all day, every day. First one is Steel Talons for the Mega Drive. Very, very good. He actually looks after his games as well, so it came with the manual. He also sold me Mech Warrior for the Super Nintendo, because he knew I was after it. So naturally, I bought it off him Very, very good. Also, for a very good price, Mage Rage. You can't go wrong with them, can you? Cannot. Next up, we've got... I'll jump through those later because they're off-brand. Next, all the Sega Saturn games. Yes, I got quite a few as well. I believe I've got more floating around somewhere, but at this moment in time, I'm not running around and looking for them. So, if they're not there and I remember what they are, I'll just let you know what they are. First up, I got this one from Sore Thumbs, as you can tell, it's in the plastic wrapping. Shell Shock. Now, this one looked pretty cool because it's a 3D tank shooting type game by the looks of it. I am all for that. I love all games like that, so naturally, I was going to jump in and get that one. Next up, a game called Mass Destruction. Unfortunately, it's missing the manual, but the best part about it is it lets you know. All the stickers on the front either say the game is missing a manual or complete with the manual. It's very, very nice, so you don't have to actually open up the packaging. It's always best to open up the packaging and check the disc, though. But you do get a warranty with it if you, you know, if you wanted to return it, you can do. But yeah, this was pretty good. Now, Mass Destruction looks a lot like... Demolition Corpse on N64. Or whatever it's called. I can't remember what it's called, but you're basically blowing up buildings and stuff. Very, very, very good. Next one, Black Dawn, Blast or Be Blasted. Very, very good. This one I got from a local video game store in one of my local towns. It's a independent game store. Very, very good. I also got Tunnel B1. Now, I've got this on PS1, but look at that packaging. That's ace. In the UK, we just got basically CD-shaped, well, slightly fat CD-shaped boxes. So these are nice and different. DVD size, but better. Fighting Vipers for the Sega Saturn. Because, of course, I had to get a fighting game. But also, because it was only £2, Sega Worldwide 97, Sega Worldwide Soccer, very, very good. International Victory Goal, it was £1. I'm not going to turn down a Sega Saturn game for £1, I'm not. Sega Worldwide Soccer 98 as well, I just got a whole bunch of them, not complaining. Virtua Fighter, disc only. Wipeout. Of course, naturally, had to get it. Duke Nukem 3D, because of course I did. There's a Cash Converter sticker on it, but I didn't buy it from Cash Converters. Whatever. That's the second, but they're notorious for having terrible freaking stickers, though. Nightmare. But I'll take it anyway. Duke Nukem 3D, very, very, very good. How that almost went. And of course, because such good things I heard about it, yes, I did spend £15 on it, but that's because I couldn't be bothered waiting for it. I couldn't. At the time, it was a good price. I don't know what the price of it is right now, but the price was all right. But I was going to get it. I've heard such good things about Doom on the Sega Saturn. It's the best. It's one of the best versions of Doom from back in this time period. So it'd be very good to actually experience it on Sega Saturn hardware. So I pretty much had to pick it up. Plus, it comes complete with the manual, which I am taking all day, every day, for my collection. Very, very good. All right, so... Next up, got this one from Sore Thumbs. The previous owner basically bought it from a shop called BT's for $19.99. Very adorable. But it's called War Games DEFCON 1. Very cool. Never heard of this game before. So naturally, I want it. I want it. Whenever I see games that are obscure, that I've never heard of before, I need them, and I will haggle the hell out of someone in order to own it. Of course, knowing what it goes for on eBay also helps as well. Next up, I've got Dragon Ball Final Bout for PS1. I've not really played many retro Dragon Ball games. Like, the most retro Dragon Ball games I've played is one for the Game Boy Color, which was absolutely garbage and card-based. I hated it. It almost put me off every Dragon Ball game ever. I didn't play any Dragon Ball games, didn't buy any, because I spent all my money on this one, brand new, when I was a child, and I was very upset by it. And then I played Budokai on PS2, and then I played... pretty much played most of the Dragon Ball games after then. Looking forward to Kakarot. I'm hoping that's good. Next up, Stock Car Racer. And of course, Spyro 2 Gateway to Glimmer. I needed to add this to my collection. I only had a disc-only copy, so now I've actually got a boxed copy. I will take it. I will take it because I need it. My collection very much needs it. Alrighty. partway there. I'm just making piles around me and hope for the best. Alright, so this one, this is the interesting pile because it's gaming related, okay? It's different. Poundland in York was selling this. Poundland. Pretty much brand new sealed. A lot of them are second-hand ones. I don't know how the hell to get hold of them. But the second-hand sticker wasn't on this, so I'm assuming this might be brand new. I don't know. Because it's really misleading when it's sealed like that, but hey, could be. Assassin's Creed. I've not watched it. I love the Assassin's Creed games for the most part. There's a couple I didn't like three, but that's mostly because the story was awful. The game was good. The story was just dreadful. Unity had actually an okay story, but it was just incredibly flawed, but most of them, I'm a big fan of Assassin's Creed, especially Odyssey. Odyssey is by far my favourite at the moment. Revelations is my all-time best, though, just because it wrapped up the story of Ezio and Altair with a nice big ribbon. But anyway, yes, Poundland, Assassin's Creed on Blu-ray. I was grabbing that. This one, not even technically, it's not gaming related. I just really, really, really enjoy the film and the books. And also, because I'm a steelbook case nerd, it's Ender's Game. Hey, there's game in the title that makes it gaming pickups related. Look, I'm stretching here. But yes, an actual steelbook. That is such a beautiful steelbook. Very, very nice. So for you steelbook collectors, very, very nice. And also, I like it when they've actually got bumps on them, so you can actually feel the pattern on it. Very, very nice. And of course, I picked that up. Very, very nice indeed. I kind of went a little bit nuts. These ones are all gaming related. I've seen pretty much every single gaming movie, video, live action, remake, animation, whatever you want to call it. I even watched, it's not gaming related, but I still watched, what's it called? Oh my god, my favourite movie. Starship Troopers, the animated movies. Good. Really, really good. I enjoy them. So I kind of went on a spending spree and found these dirt cheap and picked them all up because I needed physical versions for them. So I got Resident Evil Degeneration on Blu-ray. Damn, a really good way, like, very, very good quality way of watching this film. It's a really, really good film. Really enjoy it. If you weren't a fan of the live-action ones, you should be a fan of the animated version because it's got Leon. Leon's back. A proper Leon. This one I haven't seen, but it was on Blu-ray and I kind of needed to own it. Plus the guy who plays Jesse Pinkman's in it. What's his name? Aaron Paul? Yeah. Oh, it says it on it. There you go. Aaron Paul. Need for Speed 3D. Okay. Neat. I didn't even know there was a Need for Speed film, but apparently EA got it. Now, I was skeptical this was actually Need for Speed, the video game. I thought it was just like just a movie called Need for Speed and someone managed to get away with it. But no, it actually says Electronic Arts on the back of it. Came out in 2014, apparently, the movie. On Blu-ray, anyway. Not too sure. This one I haven't seen either, because I don't know much about this one. Halo Legends. Pretty cool. And it's a steelbook as well. I just found this in CEX for a couple of quid, and I had to own it. I had to. Bought it a month or so back. Very, very good. Plus, you guys know I'm a sucker for my steelbook. But I'd really dig the case, because, you know, it's pretty darn cool. I do like it. Kind of hope it's good. This was also in Poundland for £2. Hitman Agent 47. Again, not very well received, but I'm a video game movie nerd. I enjoy them for what they are. I mostly watch them for the references to the actual games. Because the Tekken 1 is my least favourite video game film. Because Tekken, besides the character names, didn't reference the source material that much. Not to me, anyway. I didn't agree with any of it. But it was a good film. Nice action film. Whatever, I'll take it. But anyway, I digress. Hitman Agent 47. This came into work, so naturally I had to buy it. A trilogy, triple feature. Mortal Kombat, Mortal Kombat Annihilation, and Mortal Kombat Legacy. Apparently that was a TV show. I don't know if that's episode 1 or series 1, but it was on Blu-ray, so I figured I'd pick it up. Why the hell not? All three triple features. I'll take it. Okay, this isn't video game related, but it is one of my favourite films of all time. Spaceballs. Oh, I had to own it on Blu-ray. Those are the rules. I'm trying to get all the video game films on Blu-ray. I'm trying to. I'm failing. But if I fail to find it on Blu-ray, I will get it on DVD. Dead or alive. This is such a bad film. But hey, I'll take it. Dead or alive. on DVD. This is a good film. Nice tie-in for the video games. Dead Space Downfall. Pretty good. Nice animation style. Very, very good animation style. Pick this up. Very, very nice. Wasn't the worst film in the world, but it wasn't great either. Alone in the Dark. I'll take it. I actually secretly really like this film. I try disconnecting them from the games as much as possible, because you've got to condense them, and you've got to make it available for a wide audience. You can't just make a film for a niche audience like gamers. Not that we're niche anymore, but still, you got to think about that. But this is actually not a bad film. Timothy Olyphant, yeah, he did an alright Agent 47. Talks a little bit too much for my liking, and his voice is a little bit too high-pitched to be Agent 47, but I like the film. It's a guilty pleasure. This is by far my favourite video game film of all time. Besides Mortal Kombat. Mortal Kombat, it is, because that it cheats by being amazing. But this is, without a doubt, as offensive and as stupid and as dumb and self-referential as the video game itself. Sure, it's made by Uwe Boll, but Uwe Boll has a fight with the developers of the game in the film because they hate each other, because he's terrible at making films, so naturally they fought him in the... It's dumb. It's so dumb, with George Bush and Osama bin Laden holding hands while nukes are going off. It's stupid. It is dumb, and it's the self-referential, and there's so many callbacks to the films. It is objectively the best video game movie ever. If you enjoyed Postal 2 especially, you should get at least some enjoyment out of Postal. It is dumb, it's stupid, it is not for people that don't like the game. It's one of the films that were made for pretty much the gamers. Watching Uwe Boll get punched? Also, you can't argue against that. But hey, I can understand why a lot of people hate it, but at the same time, I can't help but love it. Because Postal. Plus, Postal 4 is out. It's only day one at the moment, but it's worth getting. And of course, Doom. Not a bad film. Not a bad film. The first person part towards the end of the film before the final boss fight almost redeemed the entire film because Doom. But hey, wasn't awful. And watching Carl Urban go against Dwayne Johnson. Okay, I will take that too. That's pretty darn cool. Pretty nice. So yes, I got a ton of video game films because these need saving for posterity. And also, when you want to punish yourself for being bad, you can watch the really bad ones like Dead or Alive. Plus, Sam's not watched half of them, so naturally, she needs punishing too. Alright, next up we have... Let's fly through the Switch games. Why not? I absolutely love this game. I've been watching Chaos Mole on Mixer stream this game when it first came out. Obviously, he's not playing it now because it came out a while ago. But it came out on the Switch. The game's really, really good. I enjoyed playing on PC. And playing it portably actually really makes sense. I really enjoy this game. I hope they make another based in this universe. But hey, it's pretty good. And it's a post-apocalyptic game. Don't let the look of it fool you. It is post-apocalyptic. And the creatures are very nightmarish, despite being very cute. It's very, very nice. Reminds me very much like Harvest Moon. If you haven't already looked it up, look it up now. My Time at Portia. Add it to your list. Play it. Victor Vran, Overkill Edition, featuring Motorhead through the ages. Great band. Great game. Mixed together. Great experience. On the Switch. On the go. Plug in some earphones. Sit and get immersed. Pretty good game. I do enjoy it. I enjoyed it on PC, but I think I prefer it portably, hence why I got it. Plus, it's brand new. Brand new and sealed. I will take that all day, every day. This one, never heard of in my life, but I found this in Cash Converters in Leeds. It's apparently a procedurally generated cop action game. The premise alone makes me interested. Procedurally generated cases? Okay, I like that. Two cops, one case, and only 24 hours to take back the city. But if it's procedurally generated cases, then it's all self-contained, so you can just keep playing indefinitely. And it's two-player as well, which is pretty darn good. So you can play two-player, so you can play with the two Joy-Cons and a Pro Controller, I imagine. Pretty cool. I want to see what this is like. I almost passed this up. Stern Pinball Arcade. The front cover, pretty good, but it shows Ghostbusters, JJ Trek, AC/DC, pretty darn cool, and a car racing one that I recognise but is going straight over my head at the moment. And then I kind of read the back, and I kind of had to own it. 11 of the greatest machines from Stern Pinball, including Star Trek Vengeance Premium, JD Trek, Harley Davidson, okay, I like Harley Davidson, Mustang Premium Boss, I guess that's what that is, AC/DC Premium, okay, I'll take it, Ghostbusters, Last Action Hero, only one of my favourite films, love that, Starship Troopers, you guys know I love Starship Troopers, High Roller Casino, Phantom of the Freaking Opera, I will have that all day on night, Ripley's Believe It or Not, and Mary Shelley's Frankenstein. Okay, I'm down for some Frankenstein. Pretty darn cool, but yeah, Starship Troopers and Last Action Hero and AC/DC. I love pinball games, and having this makes me just the more happy and giddier. Very, very good. So I'm happy to get those in my collection. I need those, and now I have them. Next up, let's go through the pile of PS4 games. Yeah, I've got a ton of PS4 games, and now I've got almost another shelf of PS4 games, and they're not ones to sniff at, sniffy nose at either. They're pretty darn good. Among the Sleep being the first one. This is a pretty cute, very different premise for a video game. It's a first-person psychological horror game, okay, like they do, but you're a little kid. You're playing as a little kid. No, you don't always do that in video games, especially horror ones. I do like it. I do like the idea of it. So I looked up some gameplay real quick before I bought it, and pretty much grabbed it, and away you go. Pretty cool. Next up, I got Call of Duty Modern Warfare Remastered. Now, I thought I already had this because I got the Infinite Warfare plus Modern Warfare package. The code was used, which is the risk, which is why I only paid £1 for it. So it was a risk, but I thought I had it, and when I got home and tried the code and it didn't work, I was a little bit sad. But hey, now I have the remastered edition for PS4, very, very good, and having an active multiplayer, very good, but they're selling the DLC back to us for more than what it cost at the time. Upsets me slightly. But hey, I'm not going to buy it anyway. I don't buy DLC unless it's amazing. Outer Worlds, call me. I want some DLC. Next up, I'm a Steelbook sucker, what can I say? Destiny 1, Steelbook. It's the Xbox One version, but I'm going to cannibalise this case and swap my PS4 version out for this. Because of course I am, I'm not getting it, and I'll have a copy of it, the game for Xbox One, even though the servers will probably be down by the time I get an Xbox One. Who knows, who cares? Timefall 2, very, very fun game. It is good. It's a shame what they did with it, but the multiplayer is still active, it's still fun, and the single player is engaging. I hope for Timefall 3, but because Apex Legends is so successful, I doubt we'll ever get it. But hey, it's set in the same universe, so it could still come back. They'll just get Titanfall Battle Royale or some crap like that, which would be pretty cool. Well, I'm just thinking of a Battle Royale mech soon. I'm just enjoying that thought. Pity me, okay? Brand new, still sealed, Mass Effect Andromeda. I got it for a couple of quid because, of course, I did. The game's worthless and buggy and unfinished. But look, PS4 still sealed. I'm not going to talk about that game. Also, Deformers, brand new and sealed. Yeah, a game that came into a nice cache of brand new sealed games. I'll take it. Why the hell not? Deformers. I pretty much got it because of a burger on the back. As far as I'm aware, this game is a brick, so I'm pretty much never going to open it anyway, because I did look it up. The game is dead. It's like a multiplayer-only game, and the multiplayer's pretty much been abandoned. So it's pretty much unplayable, I think, from what I've read. But hey, it had a burger on the back and it was a quid, and it's brand new sealed. I'll take it. I got this to punish myself, because we all know I like to have a little bit of self-depreciating humour. Metal Gear Survive. It was cheap. I didn't have it. And it's Metal Gear, right? Look, it's the last physical release of Konami I'm pretty much ever going to buy. Okay, I got it out of pity. I love that. It's like, it requires the internet, yet it's like one player. Hey, this made me happy, though. Spyro! Reignite Trilogy. Unfortunately, only has game one on it. Now, do they warn you? Yeah, games 2 and 3 require download via internet. So if you haven't got the internet, you're literally only buying Spyro 1. Which is the reason why I didn't buy this game brand new. I bought it second hand because I didn't want to give the developers... Well, I didn't want to give Activision any money, basically. Because, you know, you got to vote with your wallet. But you got to vote with your wallet smart. Smart, okay? You buy it from someone who's already given Activision money. So you don't give Activision money. That's how you win. Spyro Reignited Trilogy... All three games, beautifully remastered. This is fantastic. This is amazing. But Activision, put the games on the disc. You fool. Next up, one of the best co-op experiences ever. Watching Lethal and Grimmer play this was bloody brilliant. And also, I almost pulled all my hair out from watching that. And naturally, I had to get in on the action as well. Overcooked Gourmet Edition for the PS4. Can't go wrong. Dying Light for the PS4? I love Dying Light. The girlfriend wanted to play it. She doesn't like keyboard and mouse, and, well, while I can plug a controller in the computer, I want to be on the computer. So this makes the most sense. So, yeah, got this for the girlfriend. Dying Light, very, very good game. You can't speak more loudly about it. This is The Police for PlayStation 4. Very good game. They've released a sequel now. This is The Police 2, which just continues on the amazing... This is actually really, really... It's really gritty. That's what I found. I didn't expect it. I thought it was just going to be a quaint, oh, I'm the police officer, blah, 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 blah game. No, no, no. It's actually got quite a gritty little story. I do like it. Next up. Now, you guys might remember in a Game & Pickles video from a while ago, I got Yakuza 6 Steelbook Edition... With Yakuza 0 on the inside of it. Not Steelbook Edition, but like a special edition Yakuza 6, I think it was. And Yakuza 0 disc was in it. The disc was knackered. I was depressed. Until I got this. Got a couple of weeks back. Yakuza 0. Now we can finally play Yakuza 0. Because I've been playing Yakuza Kiwami and... I want to play Zero before Kiwami, because it's Kiwami comes after, because Kiwami's a remake of the first game, and this is Zero, set before. Yeah, need it. Got a couple of VR games. This is going dirt cheap in game, brand new, by the way. Pretty darn good. It's called Smash Hit Plunder. It's a VR game where your whole objective is to go into like dungeons and procedurally made rooms and just plunder the place and loot it and get as much stuff as you can. Yeah, wreck a castle, smash alone, smash together, or smash against friends. Pretty darn cool stuff. I do like that. You can have 1 to 4 players. I want to experience this. Looks like a fun experience. Now, this looked interesting because it's, I like Vikings. It's called Vikings Wolves of Midgard. It looks like Mixard. Look at that and tell me that doesn't say Mixard. That says Mixard. It's apparently a special edition, like it matters. Special edition includes large side poster, digital soundtrack, and digital art book. Does it? Oh, yeah, so it does. Neat. I was skeptical then, because it was secondhand, but it does. What caught my eye was that it says it's a true competitor to the Diablo series. Now, Diablo 4 is currently in development, and they're looking for all the help they can get because, well, Path of Exile is kind of ruling the roost when it comes to Diablo-style games. This is apparently a competitor to Diablo, so I'm checking that one out for sure because I love Diablo. The girlfriend bought me this! Super hot. Super hot. VR. Because I wanted to get shot in the face in VR. How else do you want to play it? Pretty darn cool. Now this, I have no idea what it is, but it looked interesting enough. Ghost Giant on VR. Brand new sealed. As the Ghost Giant, you are the protector of a lonely little boy, Louis, who's in dire need of a helping hand. So you're a dead guy helping out a small child. The premise alone has my attention. I'm a ghost. I'm dead and I'm helping out this poor little child. Step into Louis' world and break the wall between protagonist and player in a highly immersive VR story. Maneuver a unique diorama world by opening roofs, grabbing cars, and rotating a whole house. While you're at it, why not use a crane as a huge fishing rod? I didn't read that. Now I'm interested. Inside the box is a code to unlock the following unique digital items. A set of beautiful postcards. Digital soundtrack. Give me all the soundtracks. I love that stuff. And characters of Sancourt digital art book. Pretty darn cool. Because it's brand new and sealed, I will have that. Another VR game. Squishies. One of the most innovative and clever VR games I've ever played. Doesn't take much for me to buy a game. That alone made me want to buy it. Because I'm after... The one thing I love about VR games is that they're a completely out-of-the-box experience. Every single VR game should be different. I don't want the type of game where you're literally just pointing at something and shooting, because that's the most basic and simple VR games can be. Make them more. And games like this do help stranded squishies find their way back home in this fantastic miniature 3D universe. It sounds like a Lemmings-type game. Probably isn't, but hey, stranded squishies find their way back home. I'm down for that. I'm a big fan of Lemmings, so hopefully it's a bit like that. But even if it's not, I want to play it. I've got Unearthing Mars. It's part of a VR collection. Apparently, Unearthing Mars 2 came out, so I still need to play Unearthing Mars 1, so... But, eh. I got the sequel because it was cheap and it's on VR, and I'm always after more VR games. I'm going through all my game collection, and I'm actually putting stickers... on the spines of ones that are VR, so when I get my VR headset out and I fancy playing a VR game, I can quickly find and play them. Because, do you remember on PS3 on the spine where it said PlayStation Move? Why isn't Sony doing that for VR? Why? Why have they not done that? I've got to physically put stickers on my games to see which ones are VR. Because if you look on the spine, how can you tell if this is a VR game? You have to pretty much remember the name, and you're just like, Unearthing Mars? Oh, it must be just a controller game if you can't remember. If you're like, well, not everybody has my problems, but surely, you know, you're gonna forget a forgettable game that is, if it's on VR and you want to give it another chance, you know, you got, make it easy for me, Sony. This one looks pretty cool. Lichdom Battle Mage? Battle your way through armies of evil in a fierce fight for justice. Gets magic combat right, according to IGN. Well, I trust you, IGN. Cast thousands of spells with 8 main sigils, fallen loot, bonus characteristics, and distinct attunements. Journey across dangerous battlegrounds, teaming with the army's undead. Well, that it doesn't take much to sell a game to me. That sounds fun. Sounds fun. And they didn't put any real gameplay pictures, but I'll take it. I had to have a physical version of this game. I haven't even got a physical version on PC. I think I've got one for the original game, but not for this one. I'm curious as to how this plays, because I've only ever played it on PC with a mouse. So how on earth do you play Mountain Blade Warband with a controller? I had to own a physical version of this damn game. It's one of the best RPGs ever made. If you are still one of the people that haven't played Mountain Blade Warband, for the love of all that is gaming holiness, buy it and play it. Whether it's on PS4, Android if you've got an Nvidia Shield, or on PC. It doesn't require a lot of resources to play. You can play Mountain Blade Warband on a relatively older PC or on a laptop. You can play it. I mean, it runs on Android. It runs on PS4. Of course, it's not that powerful. It's a really, really fun RPG. It's a tough RPG. It is not your friend. It is a brutal experience. But if you can find enjoyment in the combat, it's worth playing. Fans of... Chivalry? Oh god, that's not played anymore. What else is there? For Honor? No, nobody plays that either. Oh, there's another one. There's always one actually loads of people playing that's multiplayer. I can't remember what it's called. But yeah, playing that one. Basically, you can aim up, aim down, left and right. And if you block the right way, you can block it. Anyway, I had to buy this because I like my colony games. Avon Colony. Build a new home for humanity. I'm a sucker for building alien colonies. I'll take it all day, every day. I'm a sucker for steelbooks. So the girlfriend bought me Aether 1. Now, the reason, besides it being a steelbook, that I picked this up was because there's absolutely zero information on this. Zero. Doesn't tell me anything about the game. But the reason why I knew it was going to be a good quality game was because I've played a game from the developer before, and you know when I remember a developer name, it could be actually a really good game. It's made by Sodesco. Who are Sodesco? Well, they released Truck Driver for PlayStation 4. Because SCS Software will not listen to the fans when I say make a truck game for the PlayStation 4 and Xbox One. Now, I don't know if they've made one for Xbox One, but I know they've released it on PS4. It's a brilliant game, very good trucking game. I'm begging them to make a VR version for it because right now, my wheel could be hooked up to the PlayStation 4 and I can play it and enjoy it. But I want to put on my PlayStation VR. Because if they can beat SCS Software to the punch and make a budget-priced truck simulator game, they could take over. They won't, but still, they're doing what SCS Software won't. They say it's not possible. Sodesco proved them wrong. So, I support them. Support them by getting one of their previous games. I had no idea. It could be a walking simulator for all I know. It could be garbage. But they've made games I enjoy. And because they've made another game, I'm going to try it out. Hopefully it's good. Very good. Right, let me just make this disappear. I am making a pile of games by my feet because I've got nowhere else to put them because I need to get... There is that many games to go through. This is going to be one of the world's longest videos. I weren't joking when I said it was Game Pickups the movie. Let's keep going. Alright, so for PlayStation 3, I have Colin McRae Dirt Steelbook. Yes. Delicious. Cannot go wrong. Ooh, register your game and receive free unlocks. Do you reckon I can still do that? I don't think I can. No. I'll try anyway. Next up. At first, I thought this was a DVD. Eragon, the ill-fated film. I genuinely wanted a sequel to this film. Brr. In the meantime, I get a video game. I didn't even know they made an Eragon light video game. But they made one for PC. Fulfill the destiny of the legendary Dragon Rider. Yay! You can be your own Jon Snow! No. I'm curious, okay. It's another Steelbook copy. Battlefield Bad Company Gold Edition. I don't know if it is the Gold Edition. Don't really care. I just got this for the Steelbook. You know I'm a Steelbook collector. It's one of my favourite game franchises. EA, if you want to make some money on Battlefield, make Bad Company 3. Change the voice actors if you really care, but at least make them sound similar. That's how you win. It is. They'll never do it. They'll never do it. Maybe because Bad Company didn't sell as well as the other Battlefields is why, but they will get a lot of PR points. Not that they care. All they care about is their shareholders. Saw this. Don't have it. Sounds cool. Monster Madness. Battle for Suburbia. Over 70 unique monster enemies. Okay, you've got me. 4-player co-op. I love couch co-op games. You've got me. Over 20 gigantic levels with intense boss fights. Okay, brilliant. Highly interactive and destructible environments and devious physical traps. You've got my attention. Drive, pilot, and sail a fleet of unique monster-mashing vehicles. Now you have my erection. I mean, attention. Pretty darn cool stuff. Alright, so naturally, I got these as well. Portal 2 for PlayStation 3. Because it turns out, don't have Portal 2. I do on PC, but that's about it. Physical versions. Dan needs these for the incoming internet apocalypse. That will probably never happen, but still. Should Valve die, I can boot up an old PS3 and play their games. Little Big Planet 2. Don't know what happened to my copy. It's gone. Got another. I watched Call Me Kevin play this. And now I want to play it more than ever. Because I got this, and I shit you not, I bought this the day before his video came out when he played this. Because I had no idea what this game was. I just Naughty Bear, and it was rated T for Teen. Couldn't really buy it in the UK, I don't think. I don't know. I couldn't really find any information on it, so I had to buy it because it's not in my collection. And then I saw the gameplay, and I was like, oh my god, this is amazing. I want more. Can we have Naughty Bear for PS4? Because that is ridiculous. It is dumb. It's like Postal Boy, you're a teddy bear. A little bit. Wipeout Fury, because apparently I didn't have it. I had the other Wipeout game for PS3. I thought they were the same one. Oops. Shows how much I know. Two Worlds 2. Well, naturally. Duh. There's the figure. Mentioned it earlier. Two Worlds 2. You guys already do, but it was in the pile. Deus Ex Human Evolution Augmented Edition. Pretty cool stuff. I mean, there's all sorts in here. You get the game case, a booklet, design work. I'm down with that. There's probably meant to be other bits in here, but I have no idea. Cause, well, it was secondhand. What do you expect? Bonus disc, DVD-ROM. Pretty cool beans. I love that kind of stuff. More games should come with this stuff. Maybe on the disc, but put some like bonus stuff on it. I love this stuff like that. Like bonus stuff, like making of. I love making of DVDs. It's good to see that kind of stuff. It interests me greatly. The collector's edition for Fallout 3 with the DVD of the making of. Bloody great stuff back before Bethesda killed themselves. Brr. Got this the other day. Last week, actually. No, the week before. The week before. There you go. Every day's blurring together. Lara Croft Tomb Raider Anniversary. I don't know if it's meant to come with a sleeve, but it just came in work like this. It's pretty much a must-buy. Comes with a ton of discs. Comes with the anniversary game on PS2. Comes with the anniversary soundtrack. And the bonus disc. Again, bonus stuff. I like it. And for a small bonus, for whatever reason, the previous owner put Tomb Raider and Tomb Raider Legend discs inside of it. I guess they wanted to keep their games together. I'm not complaining. Extra games, bonus games. Like I didn't need them. Of course I need them. Next up, Tom Clancy's End War. But Dan, I thought you already had it. I do. It's a steelbook. Yeah. Wait, where's the game? Oh, I remember now. It didn't have the disc, but I bought it anyway. For $1.99. I remember now. I was just curious then. I was like, where's the disc? Yeah. Steelbook. I'm a steelbook collector. What can I say? But yeah, I've already got it on 360. That's why I bought it. I remember now. Like I said, it was a couple of weeks ago. Okay? It was the same time when I got Lara Croft. So basically, it didn't have the disc. And I was just like, you want $7.99 for a discless game? No. I will pay you $1.99, which is the going price for steelbooks. For some reason in the UK, I question nothing. So when you go in stores and you see steelbooks, have you noticed it always pretty much always says $1.99? It is in my area, don't know why. I was like, I'll pay you $1.99 for it. And they said yes, to my surprise. I call dibs, it's mine. So I will find the boxed copy that I have somewhere over there. I think that's the 360 game. Yes, it is. I will find it, and I will put the disc in there. Haha, bonus. Silent Hill Homecoming? Oh, yeah. I always freak out when I see the case cover. It's because I reversed it. I love reversible case covers. I will take that all day, every day. Case is in absolutely abysmal condition, but yeah, I'll probably swap it out for a better one. PC game, Hunting Simulator. A little freebie. Probably doesn't even work, because it does say Steam on it. But it comes with a disc. So I guess Steam's the DRM. I'm curious if they'll let me play it. Questions for later. A couple of PS2 games. Jumping on. Mac and Shao, Demon Sword. Never heard of it, but it's an Atlus game. And the moment I saw Atlus, and I saw this was a quid in a charity shop, I had to own it because it's an Atlus game. For whatever reason, I don't know whether it's virtual scarcity. Of course it's virtual scarcity. Of course that's what they do. These games hold their value. I don't know how much this is worth. Don't really care. But it's an Atlus game. And for a quid. And it's not in my collection. It's a must have. Must own. Trivial Pursuit Unhinged. Because what's unhinged about Trivial Pursuit? I don't know. Apparently I don't have many Trivial Pursuit games. I love Trivial Pursuit. It's great. You guys should play it more if you haven't already. Pinball Fun. What a generic name. There's only about three tables by the looks of it. Attack the Dragon, Love Song, and Operation Thunderstorm. And it's got anime girls on the back of it. I don't think they know who their demographic is. But hey, I'm a sucker for pinball, so I need to own it. This was recent, well, I'll say recently. A couple of weeks back, Metal Jesus made a couple of videos. PlayStation 2 Hidden Gems. He usually makes a couple of videos. It's one of his bread and butter videos, just hidden gems. This was one of them. And I had to own it, so I found it and I got it. Brand new and sealed. I got this at a bargain price. There's the little tab. I'm not pulling on it. But yeah, PlayStation 2. Still brand new and sealed. Very good. Yeah, Deep Water. What is Deep Water? It's Waterworld the video game. Waterworld, one of my favourite films, because, you know, I have many favourite films, get over it. But Waterworld, one of my favourite, because I love post-apocalyptic films. Waterworld was one of my favourites, even though it flopped. I liked it, okay, it was dumb. Yeah, giant cuttlefish, giant sea serpents, giant anglerfish become a bounty hunter of the seas. The world has basically been drowned and you're just like, going around on a boat. It's literally like Waterworld, the video game, pretty much. Travel the seven seas and capture these legendary creatures. Become a bounty hunter of the seas, you've just said that. And use the money you earn to power up your weapons and your ship. Okay. I'm in. Pretty darn cool. This is one of the rarest games in the UK. Armored Core Ninebreaker. You'll be pretty hard pushed to go on eBay right now and buy a copy for like 50 quid. 40 quid, 30 quid, I want to say. Between 30 and 50 quid. You'd be hard pressed to find one cheaper than that. They do exist, they do happen. But not as often as I like because it's not the world's most common game. I'm a massive fan of Armored Core. You know, I love my mech suits, I love my Gundam, I love everything to do with mechs, okay? Armored Core Ninebreaker eluded me for ages. I thought I finally got a copy a few months back or early in the year. And it didn't have the bloody disc in it because someone stole it from the shop. Take the case. If you got to rob something, don't just take the disc. Meh. But I finally have a copy. Unfortunately, someone put bloody stickers on the actual case. It's like, disc not kept with box, check for booklet, blah, blah, blah. I love how it says, check for booklet. There is no booklet. I don't know. Wherever this originally was before it was bought and then put in the charity shop I found it in, unfortunately it lost a manual. But I finally have a really, really good copy of Armored Core Ninebreaker. This is one of my most sought-after games ever. And now I finally have a copy. And I'm keeping an eye out for more because those things are only appreciating in value. So I need to get all of the copies. I will be the one with all of them. There can be only one owner. One. Pretty darn cool stuff. Coinciding with Metal Jesus' video, he made a wee one as well. And naturally I went on a big hunting spree for these as well. And so I bought them. First one was Battleship. He surprised me with this one because Battleship, crap. Movie. I don't even think I want to own it on DVD and Blu-ray, but I probably will when I find it. But it's not based on a video. It's not based on a video game. It's based on an actual game. But there has been video games, so technically it's a video game film. Technically, if it's a board game film, whatever. However you want to describe it. It's up to you. But apparently this game's really, really cool. Because if you look at the gameplay, I recommend watching his video to see gameplay of it. If not, just quickly look for Battleship on the Wii. Not different consoles, because it's actually a different game, but the Wii. The Wii version's different, and it looks really, really, really cool. I definitely recommend it. I want to play it. I want to play it, so naturally I bought it. Monkey Mischief, 20 games. The Wii was flooded with this crap. Naturally, I had to own it. Wrestle the alligators, dance till you drop, high-flying fun, take over the front office. Whatever. Despicable Me! Because we all need more minions. I swear to God, if they bring out another film, I will cry because all the shops will get taken over again. Right now, it's Fortnite. And then, as soon as they release another one, it's well, actually, the next one's going to be Frozen, because Frozen 2's coming out, isn't it? Or is it, if it's not already out? I don't watch it, I don't know. Dragon Ball Z Budokai Tenkaichi 2. I will take that all day, every day. Fighting games on the Wii. I actually don't have many. And I got it because it has motion controls for a fighting game.
in Dragon Ball Z. It's so disgusting, I want to try it.
Another one, Arcade Zone. Yes, that was games falling. They're all going. Arcade Zone, your favourite arcade games. And by arcade, it means places that have, like, table hockey and the throwing basketball into the hoops and whack-a-mole and stuff like that. Pretty cool. Retro games. Mega Mania, Freeway, Atlantis, and Kaboom. Neat.
I didn't have it, so I had it.
Monster Stunt Racer 4x4, one of the games in Metal Jesus' video. These games, really fun arcade racing. I'm all for arcade racing. So if someone, you know, another video gamer like myself recommends one that's got good arcade racing, I'm going to get it and add it to my collection. I need it. Same goes for Medal of Honor Heroes 2. Absolutely fun. I mean, I'm a big fan of Medal of Honor. Up until the reboot that killed the franchise. You'd think EA would know better. You'd think. But no, they were like, oh no, Activision made modern shooters. We should need to do Medal of Honor Modern Shooter 2. And then release a sequel that flopped. You'd go back to making PS World War II games, wouldn't you? You would. You'd instantly. And that's what they should have done. They should have made Medal of Honor Airborne. But as Medal of Honor Allied Assault. Remake Allied Assault in the Airborne engine. You'll make infinite money. Infinite money. Do it. Medal of Honor Heroes 2, though. Pretty darn fun. Good stuff. Wicked Monsters Blast. Another recommended game. Very, very good. Yeah, this is literally Metal Jesus video right now. These are good games, okay? It's pretty fun. Next up. Anno. Create a New World. I think it's called Discovery or something like that. Infinite Undiscovery or something, whatever it's called. I don't know. I can't remember what it's called. But it's got a different name in the United States. He called it something completely different. I looked it up and I was like, we don't have that. And I looked it up some more. It's actually a game called Anno. And you guys know I love Anno. So having an Anno game for the Wii that I didn't even know existed, and Mel Jesus inadvertently told me about it, I'll take it. I'll take it all day, every day. So if anyone's looking for that game in Europe or the UK, it's called Anno. Create a New World. Very, very good game. It's Anno for the Wii. He looks like... I don't think he knew about Anno. So, I guess he learned something new. And naturally, Sonic All-Stars Racing for the Wii. Sonic All-Stars Racing is a fantastic kart racing game. Releasing it on the Wii is a little bit backwards, though, because they've got Mario Kart, which is arguably better than Sonic All-Stars Racing, but, yeah, whatever. Yeah, potato, potato. Kart racing and all that. Alright, next up, let's get into the high wind of it. So, I recently picked up a crazy, crazy thing. Now, what did I do with it? I've misplaced it by the looks of it. I did pick up a 3DS XL. Well, first, I picked up a 3DS. Okay, neat. And then I picked up a 3DS XL. And then I shit you not, a couple of days later, a new 3DS XL came into work. So naturally, I got it. I am now an owner of the new 3DS XL, the one with the better hardware. Pretty cool stuff. I've even got myself a new 3DS XL compatible R4 card. Very, very good, because the original R4 cards could only take up to 2 GB. This one can take up to like 128 or whatever it is. So naturally, I have it now. So I've got myself an R4 card to play as many DS games as I want. I'm also going to add firmware onto it eventually that'll allow me to play 3DS games on it, but you know, until then, I've increased my 3DS collection. So let me just show you what I got for my 3DS, because someone came to work and dumped their entire catalogue of DS games, and I inadvertently bought them all over the course of a month. I don't even know where to begin. I really, really, really don't. So let me just move the ball over here first. There's some. Oh, can't let that disappear. Go. There we go. There's that pile there. Yeah, this is going to be a fun one because there's loads. There's quite a few. Let me just put that there. Put that there. Put that there. And put that there.
There's a lot here. I'll just jump onto the PSP game, because there's only two of them. Twisted Metal Head-On and Metal Gear Acid. That's cool. I already had this as cart-only version, but now I've actually got a box copy with manual and everything. I will take that all day, every day. It's all mine. It is all mine. Alright, so next up we have... Where the hell did I put it? There it is. Done. Ba-ba-ba. I just have a million and one games for the DS now. Maybe too many? But I disagree. There's no such thing as too many. Ever. So let's get started, shall we? Let's go for... this pile. Alright, so I got this pretty much for free. It was a quid at Cash Converters in... Where was this one? My local city, I think, this one. They're all over the place. You'll find them. Mushy Monsters Katsuma Unleashed. Pretty darn cool. For a quid. I was going to pick it up. Of course I was. Comes with the manual as well. But the manual's like 3 pages big. But I'll take it anyway. It'll do me nicely. Next up, Transformers Dark of the Moon Stealth Force Edition. No idea, but it looks pretty darn cool. Transformers games on handheld devices have always been fun. Always. So I will always pick them up when I see them. Dead or Alive Dimensions for the 3DS. Very cool beans. Pilot Wings Resort? No idea. It's a flying game. So I was pretty much going to buy it. I do have... Where are you? What did I do with you? I don't know. I kind of went a little bit full ham with this person's collection when they sold it to us. They kind of had it... They were just like me. They love jewel games. You know, like Bejeweled. So I kind of got quite a few of them. So I'm going to fly through them quick because not everybody loves them. But these ones are really good. So if you do like match 3 games like I do, these ones are pretty darn good. Jewel Link Legend of Atlantis 3D. It is literally the DS version, but on 3DS. They didn't do much to change it. I know this was released on DS. And I think I've got it somewhere. That's why I was looking for it. Because I think it might have been in this pile. But I guess it's in the on the shelf somewhere. But yeah, I do have this. Jewel Link. They've made a ton of these. They're essentially the same game, but with different palettes and different themes. But it's essentially the same game. So if you get bored of like the Greek version, then you've got the Atlantis version. Then I think there's a Rome version. But they're all the same, but they're different in their own little ways. But if you like Match 3, it's a way to keep your collection varied and, you know, don't feel like you're playing the same game over and over. It's pretty good. So, yeah, another Jewel Link game, Legend of Athena. Pretty good. There's also a whole bunch in here. I'm not going to go through them all, so I'm just going to throw a whole bunch of games out. Final Fantasy 3. That impresses me. The fact that they re-released Final Fantasy 3, but on the DS. I had no idea they did that until I found this, so I had to grab it. Next up, Scrabble 2008 edition. Like it makes a difference. I'll take it. Rock Band 3. It's curious. Curious. Another Guitar Hero one exists, but I don't know how they've done the Rock Band part. I don't know how you'd play it, because I don't think it uses the controller. So I don't know. That's why I got it. Professor Layton and Pandora's Box. If you like your mystery type games, very, very good. Jewel Crest Solitaire. I love Solitaire. I love Match 3. Done. The Lost Treasures of Alexandria. Another Match 3 game. Very good. Jewel Match 2. They're very generic. And apparently I got 2 copies of Solitaire. Question nothing. Mistakes were made. Jewel Quest, Mysteries, Curse of the Emerald Tear, or Tear, but I imagine it's Tear because it looks like a tear. Don't know. I like my Jewel games, but like I said, not everybody's into them. I am. Puzzler World 2011, how it's different from Puzzler World 2010, I will never know, but there it is. Professor Layton and the Curious Village, the most common Professor Layton game, but still sets the standard. Very, very good series. Here's a controversial one, which is probably why it's still sealed. The Sun. Crossword Challenge. Yeah, The Sun is a very controversial newspaper. I can see why they're controversial, but at the same time, I don't care. Because all I care about games and fairness in the world, I guess. I don't know. I'm not going to pretend to know. But, yeah, it's controversial. It's probably why it's not been opened. But, hey, I've got a brand new sealed version of The Sun Crossword Challenge. A lot of people want me to burn this. But it deserves to be preserved and remembered for the controversies, right? Right? Right. Take a break's Puzzle Master. Take a break. They, for those of you who live outside the UK, I don't know how far their reach goes, so, but I can only tell you what I know about the UK. Take a Break, mate, is a gossip magazine in the UK. I only know that because my mum used to read it or still reads it. I don't know. But, yeah, Puzzle Master. It's got, like, boards and crosswords. Basically, it's the puzzles you'd get in the magazine, but on actual cartridge. Okay, basic. I'm going to assume all these... I never knew these, like, newspaper and magazine companies made games, but here we go. That could be a video in itself. Crazy Pig. What? Meet Crazy Pig, this fearless farmyard freedom fighter. Okay. There are some weird games in this series. Star Wars 2, the original trilogy. Pretty cool. Can't go wrong with Lego Star Wars games. They're pretty much always fun. Rune Factory, a Fantasy Harvest Moon. Could have sworn I already owned it, but... Oh, maybe it was on PSP. I think it was on PSP, wasn't it, guys? You guys know more than I do. Drawn to Life, SpongeBob SquarePants. Taking that. Crime Lab, Body of Evidence. Now, this is basically a CSI game without being CSI. So if you like CSI games, Crime Lab's really, really good. Rainbow Islands Revolution, very, very fun game, very fun series. I definitely recommend that one. Touch and Play Collection, 50 games, including retro, classic, arcade, puzzle, card, and board games. It literally says nothing that's on it, really. There's a picture of kind of Space Invaders, but not. On the back, there's a Snakes and Ladders, and there's a couple of dice. Oh, here we go. Including favourites such as Snickers, Ladders, Blackjack, Myong, Dominoes, and Invaders. Ant-Invaders. Ant-Invaders! So it's not Space Invaders, it's Ant-Invaders. Dumb. I'll take it. Alright, let's move on to the 3DS titles. I am down for all of this. First up being 3D Game Collection. I like my game compilations. It's nice carrying a cartridge with a ton of games on. I got these because I didn't actually have the R4 card at the time, and I needed a bunch of games to take on my 3DS XL while we're on holiday. Boom. These very much come in handy. Oh, look. Puzzler World 2013. I wonder how much it differs from the 2011 edition. Arcade Classics 3D. Another compilation pack. Blocks... Pop It Up, Swap, Impacts, Jewels, and Bounce and Break. It's basically got a whole bunch of like Atari clones on it. Pretty cool stuff. Monster Hunter 4 Ultimate. Hell yes. Give me some of that. I'll take it all day. Tales of the Abyss. If you love RPG games, here's a really good one here. Definitely recommend that. More 50 classic games. 1,000 levels. Never-ending fun. Exciting. The Legend of Zelda Triforce Heroes. Again, brilliant bloody games, and I've got them all on my 3DS. Next up, Kingdom Hearts 3D, Dream Drop Distance. Because the world needs more Kingdom Hearts games, there's no shortage of them. Another Professor Layton game, this one is And the Miracle Mask. Very, very, very good. And I also picked up, I never knew these existed. Obviously I knew the games existed. Nintendo 3DS. Steelbook cases. You what, mate? You what, mate? They have my attention. Found this in one of my local cash converters. Boom. Which one's this one? Omega Ruby. Steelbook copy. It was only a tenner at the time, which is pretty darn cool. I think I bought this like a year ago. It's been on the back burner, okay? But I never knew these existed. Pretty darn cool. And the reason why I picked this up to show you guys, because I don't think I told you guys about this one. I got this. it actually came with the original game and the steelbook together. So I'm assuming this is how they came. Because at first I thought they came like this. But I'm assuming now they came in an actual case so you could actually choose which case you could choose from. Because this is Pokemon Sun Steelbook Edition. Naturally, I've already put the game inside of it. Pretty cool stuff. But not only that, but on the inside of the steelbook case, they're not blank. They've actually got the map in it. It's really, really cool. I didn't know these existed. But apparently they do. But there's nothing on the spine. Ruined. Absolutely ruined. You have to remember through like, memory of which ones they are. But I didn't know they existed. How many more exist? If you guys know of any other steelbook games for the DS, tell me. I need to find them and own them. All of them. Next up, Angry Birds Trilogy. How cool is that? That it's actually such a novel concept, such a simple concept. But it's got Angry Birds on the DS. It's an app. But if you're a kid without a smartphone, you can get it on your DS. Clever, because it's got a touchscreen. You can use the stylus instead of your finger, or you just use your finger if you want. The three best-selling Angry Bird games in one. Exclusive Street Pass content and over 100 hours of addictive gameplay. Clever. I like that. Clever. Splinter Cell 3D. I love Splinter Cell. I love 3D. I'm curious as to how a Splinter Cell game converts over to DS. Because I've played one in the past, but I think it was actually on an old Sony Ericsson phone. It was one of the Java games. I'm sure you remember them if you had those back in the day. They were alright, I guess, but it was like 2D side-scroller. Wasn't very good. Lego Marvel Super Heroes Universe in Peril. Of course you get to play as all your favourite Marvel heroes. What's not to love? To celebrate the movie coming out, get out a video game. Detective Pikachu. This time voiced by, what's his name? Oh, I've forgotten. A big actor plays him. Danny DeVito. That's the one. I forgot his name then. I remembered. Mario Party Island Tour. Pretty cool stuff. Puzzler 3D 2012 edition. I've got them all. I don't know what the difference is. Maybe I'll find out. Street Fighter 4 3D edition as opposed to the 2D edition. Question nothing. Resident Evil The Mercenaries 3D. I need games for my 3DS. Got it. Asphalt 3D. So you know the game series that's on mobile? It's on DS now. Pretty cool stuff. Loads of mobile games have come over to the DS. Never knew that. Because I never had a 3DS. And now I can enjoy them all. And next up, Lego City Undercover, The Chase Begins. Lego City Undercover was one of my favourite Lego games ever made. It was such a unique new thing. And it was very clever. The comedy was good. The gameplay was good. It was like a GTA game in Lego form. I really hope this is like that as well. So because there wasn't any real GTA games on the original DS. There was just Chinatown Wars. Now, I don't know about the 3DS. I need to look it up. There might be. I don't know. But if this is anything like the actual console release, I will have a GTA game to play on DS. Pretty darn cool stuff. Alright, so last, but finally no means least, a couple of PS1 games. A couple anyway. First up is Dino Crisis 2. Unfortunately, the jewel case is cracked there, which is a shame, so I'll have to replace the front of that, because you can't replace them. So once they're broke, they're broke. But yeah, Dino Crisis 2, very, very good game. Very well sought after as well. SmackDown 2. Blam Machine Head. This one I actually ordered offline from a Cash Converters in, I think it was down near London. And it was literally only £2.95. Cool beans. Yeah, Blam Machine Head. Pretty darn cool. Next up, Yu-Gi-Oh! Someone bought it from Game for $19.99. Adorable. Forbidden Memories. Never played a Yu-Gi-Oh! Video game before. Tried the card game. Love that. Love the anime. Let's try some actual video games, starting with one of the first, I imagine. Let's play it. Pretty darn cool. I was one of the few people that enjoyed this. Does anyone remember this?
absolute disgusting 3D animated cartoon. So back in the day, you only had 2D animated cartoons. You had regular 2D regular cartoons, and you had anime. Then they released things like this, Cubix, Robots for Everyone, a 3D animated thing. Now they're all 3D cartoons. They look horrible. I still don't like them. They still make me feel sick, but whatever. I guess kids are going to be used to them now. But this was one of the first, and I actually really like Cubix. It was clever. It was different. It made no sense, but it was mildly entertaining, and I liked Cubix. It was pretty cool. Cubix. It's because it's got a C on his chest. Can transform into pretty much everything. The toy was cool. I liked the toy. I never got it. But I liked it. I wanted it. But yeah, Robots for Everyone. Pretty darn cool. And last but no means least, Street Fighter 2 Collection. Apparently it's got more than one Street Fighter 2 on it. There's your problem right there. Why is there so many versions of Street Fighter 2? Yeah, there is. Street Fighter 2, The World Warrior. Street Fighter 2, Champion Edition. Street Fighter 2, Turbo Hyper Fighting. I love Street Fighter, but I'm not a diehard fan, so I'm not... to me, this just screams we've got three same games on it. I don't know what the difference is between them all. Introduced faster game speed and airborne special attacks. So you couldn't do airborne special attacks before that? I guess not. Basically, they just kept... making Street Fighter 2 better, didn't they? It was just their way of introducing DLC by releasing the whole game again with updates. I get that's... Hey, I finally figured it out. Congratulations, I'm now a diehard fan of Street Fighter 2. I know everything there is to know. Enjoy your DLC. There isn't DLC. Expansions! Yes, that's what they used to be called. I love how that's left our vocabulary. Expansions, 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 expansion packs. They don't exist anymore. Make it. Make expansion packs a thing again, dammit. Makes me happy. Now, I probably do have more games.
And I do. I was about to end the video an hour and a half in, and there's more.
A lot more. Bear with me for a second while I, There's a lot to unpack here. There we go. I'm just going to flatten these. I'm going to put them all on top of these games.
It's my nice new table. It's a pile of DS games. There we go. Right, okay. So.
Most of these came from Sore Thumbs. You know that shop I mentioned earlier? Only like an hour ago. Most of these games came from there. Like I said, he had a bit of everything. And in the video, in the short little clip I showed of that shop, I think I showed you the tray that is the Game Boy range. I bought a lot of them. But there's always more. He gave me this for free, because I guess he just didn't want to charge me for it. Tony Hawk's American Wasteland. Awful game, but it's for GameCube, and I didn't have it. So now I do. So I got a copy of The Grinch on Game Boy Color with the manual. Yeah, a Game Boy game with a manual. Say it isn't so. It is. It happened. It exists. Still got Frogger Helmet Chaos. Cart only. And the rest. Oh, got a couple of other games in here. Mahjong Quest. However you want to pronounce Mahjong, but it's Mahjong Quest Expeditions. Ridge Racer DS. It's just loads of games here. I'm just going to fly through them as quickly as possible. Robots for Game Boy Advance. You know, that ill-fated film that was meant to spark a franchise and it never did. But it did make video games. I played it on PS2. It was an alright game. It was pretty much Ratchet and Clank. I'll take it. Just not as cool. Pokemon Mystery Dungeon. Red Rescue Team. Hell yes. Been playing a bunch of Blue Rescue Team on my new 3DS XL. It's pretty fun. I like the Mystery Dungeon series. Apparently there's a million more games now, so I need to pick those up at some point. But I'd rather finish these first. So I've got Red Rescue Team on Game Boy Advance and Blue Rescue Team on DS. I liked what they did there. It was clever.
Hot Potato Bam. I saw this and I had to own it because Sam was wearing potato socks. I'm not going to elaborate on that, but she was wearing potato socks. They're basically socks with potatoes on. Sonic Advance 2. Pretty cool beans. I do like that. Next up, Game and Watch Gallery. I don't know which gallery. Apparently, it's been ripped. But yeah, Game and Watch Mario. Banjo Pilot, for those of you who are fans of Banjo and Kazooie, like me. Fun stuff. Should be giddy about that one. Boulder Dash. Fantastic game for the original Game Boy. I have to own these things. Pinball Dreams by Game Tech on Pinball. Now, Game Tech, didn't they make... No, I'm thinking of Game Track. No, Game Tech. They are famous for something else as well, aren't they? Not Game Track, but Game Tech. I'll have to remember. They made something else. Pac-Man Collection for Game Boy Advance. Hell yes, give me that. Crash Bandicoot 2 Entranced. Cool beans. I think these ones were actually made by... No, I don't think they were because it was Activision. Vicarious Visions. I don't know. But I know Vicarious Visions made a ton of Crash Bandicoot games on Game Boy, and they were amazing. Which is why I knew they'd make a fantastic and authentic remake on PlayStation 1 and Xbox One, and they did. I'm very happy about that. Mario Kart Super Circuit for Game Boy Advance? Hell yes. Capcom Star Wars for Game Boy? Hell yeah. I'll take that. Cosmo Tank? Some old retro games for Game Boy, and I can't wait to pull out my original Game Boy DMG01 and just play on it. I'm looking forward to playing these. Got a bunch of Game Boy Color games that were Game Boy games. I love these. These are really cool, and I had to own these because, well, I only ever owned a couple, and I found a shop, Sore Thumbs, that had a tray of them. All different Game Boy Color games that were the transitional period that were backwards compatible with original Game Boy. You can play them on Game Boy and Game Boy Color with Color. Clever. Operation Carrot Patch, Bugs Bunny and Lola Bunny. Pretty cool beans. I liked Bugs Bunny's game on Game Boy. Can't remember what it's called, but it was brilliant. One of my first ever games. Sylvester and Tweety, Breakfast on the Run. I guess they made a whole bunch. Daffy Duck, Foul Play, classic Looney Tunes. Turns out I picked up two of the same game. I'll take that. Ah, but one's American. So that Game & Watch game is actually Game & Watch 2. But the copy with a good cover is the American version. Neat. Let me just check if it's legit. A quick and easy way of telling whether a Game Boy game is fake or not, and this goes from Game Boy to Game Boy Color to Game Boy Advance, is if you shine it under a light, there's a number very faintly stamped onto it, and it's only visible with light because it's indented into the sticker. Whenever you see an E for Everyone sticker or an American sticker, half the time they're fake, especially in the UK. I feel sorry for Americans because it's a lot harder to tell the fakes when you're not looking for the American sticker. But in the UK, we don't use American stickers, so it's easier to see. Oh, and there's the stamp there. Stamp number 20. Stamp number 20 on this one as well. Pretty cool. And another way of seeing is also when you look inside at the contacts, just above the contacts, it'll usually say Nintendo. Now, some fakes do say Nintendo, so it's not a foolproof way of finding out, but it is one of the ways of seeing whether you've got a real one. So you can quickly look at it. If it's got a stamp and it's got Nintendo, chances are it is real because it's a lot of effort, but a lot of the really good fakes, like Pokemon, they did managed to do that, so it's a lot harder, but that's a quick and easy way. And also checking the font on the back, physically identical. And of course the screw, fakes will sometimes use a Phillips screw instead of the star-shaped screws. There you go, my small little education. An hour and 30 minutes inside of the video. Have a bit of education for your time and effort. But it's have a little look on articles online. There's a million different ways, but they're all different, and not all of them are the same. Frogger,
for the Game Boy and Game Boy Color. Battle Tanks for the Game Boy Color.
Pretty darn cool.
Swiv. Never heard of these things. I will take them. So many unique sounding games. You'd never see these on PS4 or anything like that. Games called that. Deadly Skies. You'll probably see that on PS4. But yeah. Disney's Tarzan.
Okay. I will take that all day, every day. Give me that.
Super Mario Bros. Deluxe. Hell yes. Super RC Pro-Am. I'm never going to pretend to know anything about that, except that it's a racing game. Xena the Warrior Princess. Hell yeah. Gimme. Aliens Thanatos Encounter. I have no idea they made Alien games that far back. Or at least I did and I forgot. What else we got? Nickelodeon's Back in Barnyard Games, or whatever it's called. Don't know. Mystery Case Files. Millionaire, as in heir to your throne. Harry Potter and the Goblet of Fire. I love my Harry Potter games.
Did you put your name in the Goblet of Fire?
He said calmly. Oh, and of course some PlayStation Vita games. The Muppets. Movie Adventures for the Vita, card only. And Little Big Planet for the PlayStation Vita as well. Pretty darn cool stuff. Very small cartridges. Even smaller than the Switch. I'll take it. Is that everything? That is everything.
We're done. It only took us an hour and 40 minutes or more.
There's been a lot of games, and there is always more to add on to it. We're at 7,000 plus games, and we're going to keep going until we own every single game in history, minus all the sports games, because, yeah. But I'll have the retro ones, because that's cool. But seriously, I'm not, as a game collector, I'm not collecting for complete collections. I think that is a waste of time and resources, and not only that, shelf space, of which is now coming at a dangerous premium, as you can see. Piles are growing. We're getting more and more all the time. But we're also adding to all the collections. I cleared up all of here. You may have seen in my previous videos this changing around a little bit above me. That's only because I'm collecting more and more collector's editions. I've got shelves upon shelves of stuff, of stuff, of stuff. I've even got shelves of things like T-800s, the big fat guy from Monty Python squirting out sauce because he puked crazy and then exploded because, what was it, Monty Python's Meaning of Life, I think it was in. Very hilarious. Got Star Wars, Star Trek. Oh my god, I did the thing. Don't kill me. Star Trek ships. I've got the NX-01 refit. I've got all sorts. I've just been collecting all these different figures to add to my collection just because I like things. I like all these things, because I always held off from them. I was like, they're just gimmicky things. But I like getting figures and statues and collector's editions of the games I genuinely really enjoy. Like, the most obscure up there is the Two Worlds 2 collector's edition. I really thoroughly enjoyed that. There weren't many good Western RPGs on the PS3, but Two Worlds 2 and Two Worlds 1 were definitely among there. They were like the budget Skyrims. They really were. They were like really, really budget Skyrims. Very buggy, but still highly entertaining. And I enjoyed them. I enjoyed them for what they are. And of course you got Doom, Gears of War, very important. Dark Souls, because, of course, Dark Souls. And of course my own Terminator Skull up there and everything. And the Fallout 4 Pip-Boy edition. Because Fallout, even though Bethesda's completely murdered it, still one of my favourite franchises of all time. It's a shame what Bethesda have turned into, but I can't fault their original games. It's good. Their Fallout 3 is still one of my favorite games of all time. Publishing New Vegas, still one of my favorite games of all time. Still prefer 3, but New Vegas is the better Fallout game. Shush. I said it. Fallout 4, terrible Fallout game, but I've got like 1,000 hours in it because it's such a fun game. Fun post-apocalyptic experience. You can't fault it. And with all the mods, you can't fault the game. It's brilliant. It's just a terrible Fallout game. And the writing was on the wall, and I knew immediately 76 was going to be a dud, and It's the dud that keeps on giving. It's going to keep getting in the news. It's going to keep getting in the news until Bethesda do something else really stupid that makes us think about a different game. I'm expecting Starfield to completely hit the fan. Because, it's really difficult to talk about because Bethesda are killing themselves. I'm digressing, this is Game of Pickles. But they're literally killing themselves and they're setting their next games up for failure. Madness. They need to do something, but they're imploding, so... Hey, that's that. Hey, let's add it on a better note. More games are coming. More games are here. Oh, for God's sake, Dan. I'm still finding games everywhere. Technically, not games. Remember the movie SWAT? I've got that on PSP now. And Little Britain. And, of course... These
were the free pile. These were all free.
Because they're literally crap. Hannah Montana for the DS. This could be a super rare game. Nobody's ever gonna know. The sticker's been ripped off. Could be fake. Don't know. Don't care.
Imagine fashion designer.
Imagine detective. Oh boy.
Pass your driving theory test. Top model, ye.
I don't think that's going to focus at all, is it? Yep. Top model, ye. There we go.
Mind quiz, your brain coach. Bratz Diamonds and Lego Star Wars 2, the original trilogy. Yeah, they were in the free pile because they're not the best things in the universe at all. And two Game Boy Advance games, but I believe they're fake. I know one... they are definitely fake.
Two fake Game Boy Advance games. That's why they're in the pile over here, because I don't know what the hell to do with them.
Hello Kitty, Happy Party Pals. Yes, somebody faked a Hello Kitty game.
Look at how blurry that cover is. That E for everyone is blurry, and that's not just the video quality. That is actually that blurry, I promise you.
Yep. Pretty fake. And even on the inside, it doesn't say Nintendo.
I don't think they all say Nintendo, although I think they do. I don't know, but this one doesn't say Nintendo on the inside either. It's quite clearly a fake.
This one also doesn't say Nintendo on the inside, and...
I think you can probably see what's wrong with this. The Simpsons Road Range for Game Boy Advance. Now, the games do work, and they are the right games. But hopefully you can see the colour difference. That's not good at all. And also the sticker's a little bit off-centre as well. Good old fake games. Can't go wrong.
But yeah.
I don't have these games in my collection, so... Don't know what to do. Like, do I count it? Is it my game collection? I guess I could put it in my game collection and put a bracket next to it saying, fake. So I can replace it with a real version when I actually find it. So it turns out I do have it, and if the price is reasonable enough, replace it with a real one. But who knows? Who knows indeed? And
more DS cards? What are these? An R4 game cart. Another R4 game cart. My word, coach. And Crash Bandicoot Boom Bang.
There we go. Done. I'm done. It's it. It's over. It's done. It's finished. No more games to add to the game collection. And if there is more, tough, they're not getting added. I need to stop looking around because I will see more. But anyway, yes, I want to thank you guys for supporting the channel and supporting me. I do apologize for being MIA. It's one of the problems when you work in a full-time job. Unfortunately, you wake up in the... I'll tell you my schedule right now. I wake up, have a breakfast, go to work. All day. Get home at about 6, 7 o'clock at night. Have my dinner. Chill. Go to the game room at about 8. And that's my free time starting until 10 o'clock. So I get about 2 hours free time. And most of that is me watching YouTube videos, catching up on my YouTube videos, hopefully catching up on my TV shows as well. because I'm a big DC fan, and I'm really looking forward to this year's the CW crossover event, Elseworlds. So I'm pretty much staying caught up with Batwoman, Supergirl, Flash, even Black Lightning, because apparently Black Lightning's going to be in it as well. They're crossing that over. Pretty cool stuff. It's going to be good. It's literally going to be Infinity War and Endgame, but for the CW TV show. I'm really interested to see how a TV show is going to do this, because they're clearly putting a lot of money into it. It's pretty cool. I'm really excited for it for a number of reasons, but I don't want to get into too much spoiler territory with it. But the crossover event's going to be good. It's going to have really, really, really good crossovers. I'm just going to say one thing that's a little bit spoilery. But Kevin Conroy's going to be in it. If you don't know who he is, then move along. If you know who he is, you know to be excited. I know I am. Even if it's a small part, it's all I need. It's all I need. It's the closest I will ever get to a live-action version of him. Even if he's an old guy. There's more discussions on that later. Or in the Discord, if you want it to be. But yeah, I'm going to thank you guys for supporting me. I am trying to get a hang of things. My plan right now is to try and make as much free time as possible for the YouTube channel. And then I'm going to try with the streaming. For now, streaming is on the shelf. It has to be. It's easier than making a YouTube video, but YouTube makes me money. Streaming's a passion thing. Streaming, I'm just streaming while I'm playing a game, but because I only play a game for a few hours, people might not want to watch me stream for a few hours. I don't know. You'll have to let me know. I don't know. I really don't. I really don't. That's why I've put YouTube in the forefront of my attention to try and make time for, and streaming on the back burner. But hey, maybe I'll swap. Who knows? Don't know. I love both, and I wish I had time for both, but unfortunately I work all week. I work 5 days a week, and I get 2 days off, two random days a week off. Can't really make many plans, so guess we'll have to wait and see. But thank you for sticking by me and watching this absolute train wreck of a Game & Pickups movie. I think this is officially the longest Game & Pickups video that wasn't streamed. Because looking at how long it's gone on now, imagine if it was streamed. Add a good 2 hours onto that if it was streaming, because you guys are great. You guys are great, and we always get sucked away with time. I love you all, guys, very much. Stay safe, survivors. And let me know what games you guys picked up recently. And what games you think I should look at and get. Especially the retro ones. My collection, it needs feeding. And any collector's editions that are going cheap as well. I must also add those, because I need them. Always. Anyway, enough. Let's end it now. Take care, survivors.